Hi, I'm Andrea Claussen, and today we're going to do a yoga practice for the mind. So with the yoga practice for the mind, we're really going to kind of work on grounding down and connecting to our true self and our essence. So I'm personally sitting up on a blanket. You can use a yoga block, you can use a bolster, whatever you want to do, but sometimes it feels nice to kind of just shift our pelvis and rotate our pelvis downwards. So we're going to start with just a few three-part breath, kind of grounding breath work. So if you guys are new to three-part breathing, I'm going to explain it to you. Guys, if you are familiar with it, go ahead and go into your three-part breathing. So if you want to start with me, we're going to go ahead and bring our hands to our belly, and we're just going to go ahead and fill up our belly with air. So really breathing into that belly, feeling it expand as we inhale, and as we exhale, pulling our belly button in towards our spine. Just doing that a few more times following your breath. Really feeling that belly expand and contract. Next, we're going to go ahead and take our hands. We're going to bring them to our ribs. So just feeling that breath coming into our ribs. So feeling the expansion in the side bodies. And that contraction. And then finally, we're going to bring our awareness to the top of our chest. And feeling that expansion and contraction in the chest. And then we're going to put it all together. So we're going to breathe into our belly, then our ribs, and then our chest. Exhale, chest, ribs, belly. So really focusing on our expansion as we breathe in. And then really releasing that down. So doing that a few more times, breathing into that belly, ribs, chest, exhale, chest, ribs, belly. Now that's the three-part breath that you can do at any time that you feel a little anxious or just really want to connect back to the breath. So that would be a practice you can bring into your day. So the rest of what we're going to do, we're going to kind of come back, we're going to finish with actually another breath work practice, but we're going to first do a few gentle little yoga poses to really get out of our body, get out of our mind and into our body, I should say. So if you guys have a yoga block handy, we're going to need it for our next pose. I'm going to take my yoga blanket off from underneath me, but I'm going to bring my block with me as I lie down on my back. And I'm going to have my feet and my heels planted firmly on the ground. And so we're going to start, before I use that yoga block, I'm just going to have us do a few warm-up bridges. So we're going to push down through our heels. And as I do that, I'm just going to tilt my pelvis backwards and lift my hips about half an inch off the ground. And then I'm going to lower back down. As I'm lowering back down, I'm really trying to make sure I'm articulating my spine one vertebrae at a time. So I'm coming up, and then I'm trying to articulate down one vertebrae at a time. Every time I'm coming up now, I'm going to try to raise myself maybe just a half an inch higher than the last time. So we're just slowly adding a little bit more height, a little bit more depth as we go up and down. So lifting our hips up, pushing up through those glutes, and then lowering back down. So on this next one, I want you guys to go up as high as you can and holding it here for a breath. Go ahead and grab that yoga block if it's handy. Place it under that low back. Now, this should be in a spot where it feels good. If it hurts or causes you pain, try to readjust. I personally like it right above my glutes and right below that low back. So it just feels yummy here. So palms are going to be up to the sky for a little bit more receiving, palms down for grounding. Just focusing on what you can release. Maybe both in your body and in your mind. What do you need to release? Doing any sighing breaths to have extra just release in the body. Staying here for one more breath. And then on your exhale, go ahead and lift those hips up and then go ahead and take that block away from that low back. I want you guys to pull the knees into the chest, giving them a hug, just rocking side to side. Feel that deliciousness. And then we're going to go ahead and roll over to our left side, pushing up into our hands, coming back up to that seated position. If you want, you can incorporate your blanket or your bolster again and take a seat on that. sit cross-legged. We're just gonna do a little bit of spinal warm-up, and we're gonna take our arms up overhead. We're gonna go ahead and grab that left wrist, pulling it up and over to the side. With every exhale, you're focusing on deepening that stretch, just getting that side body to open. Chest is lifted up to the sky. And then we're gonna go ahead and exhale. We're gonna switch sides. Just going that opposite direction, just feeling that side body open. And what can you release again? What keeps coming up for you? Those arms down. As we release down, we're going to go ahead and take that right arm down to the top of our left knee, left arm behind the body, and we're just going to do a nice gentle twist here. So with every inhale, we're focusing on lengthening, exhale, deepening that twist. We're not going too deep. This is all really a gentle practice today. Some space. And the exhale, coming back up to center. Taking a nice inhale, lengthening. Exhale, twisting to the opposite side. So lengthen first, and then with the exhale, deepening that twist. Exhale, coming back out of that, arms coming up overhead. We're going to go ahead and take our hands behind our body, behind our mat. We're going to just do a little heart opener, a chest expansion. Gaze can be up towards the ceiling, or if you want, you can drop that head back. Whatever's going to feel good, just to get that opening in that chest. Exhale, we're in a forward fold, so taking it down now, your head down towards the earth. I'm going to back up just a little bit so you can see me, taking those hands down. And the forehead can come to a block if it's handy, to the earth, whatever you think your body needs, just releasing. Maybe you take it to the lower edge of a block. And again, using those sounding breaths if that feels good in your body. And then slowly coming back up out of that one. And then we're going to finish with alternate nostril breathing. And so if you need to, you might need to grab a Kleenex and blow your nose first. Otherwise, if you're at home, you might not care because no one might be there with you. Or if you have kids around, your kids aren't going to care. You know, a few snot bubbles happen to come, because that's what sometimes happens with this practice. So what you're going to do, you're going to go ahead and you're either going to bring your fingers to your third eye, or you're just going to fold in your pointer and middle finger. Your thumb and your index finger, your ring finger, are going to close your nostril. Your pinky is just going to kind of hang out. So we're going to bring in those fingers. We're going to close our right nostril. We're going to breathe in through the left nostril. And then you're going to close your left nostril with your ring finger and exhale out the right nostril, releasing that right thumb. Inhale in through the right nostril, closing off the right nostril, exhaling out the left nostril. Inhaling in through the left nostril, closing that left nostril off, opening up the right, exhaling out that right side. Taking an inhale in through the right side. Closing off the right side, opening the left, exhaling out the left side. Inhaling in through that left side. Closing that left side, exhaling out the right. Inhaling in through the right. And exhaling out the left. And then just go ahead and release those hands down to the ground or down to your thighs. A nice grounding gesture. And I'm just going to leave you here for about 30 seconds just to kind of soak in the practice, and just noticing any shifts in your body and your mind. Slowly bow your chin towards your chest. Blink of those eyes open if they were closed. And hopefully you guys feel a little bit more balanced, a little bit more grounded after today's practice. And noticing you can always come back to those breath works, the three-part breath we did in the beginning, and the alternate nostril breathing. Those are perfect for any time that you feel anxious or stressed. Breaking those out in a bathroom, in the car, wherever you need those. All right, until next time, Andrea.